This video is on how to use Google Classroom, specifically how to work inside each class. Once you have logged into Google Classroom, you will see all of your classes. All you have to do is double click the title to open one of your classes. If you don't have any classes and you need assistance, I also have a video called Joining and Deleting Classes. Once you open your class in Google Classroom, you're going to see three tabs at the top, and we'll talk about each one of those as we go along. You will also see on the right-hand side your waffle that allows you access to other apps. I'll make another video for how to do that. And you also see your icon. In this case, I'm using my daughter's account, Grace, so she has a G for Grace. And I'll do another video for changing that icon if you want. But most importantly, how do I do what my teacher wants me to do? So let's start with the upcoming area that is on the left-hand side. Right there, you will see any assignments that are coming up for that class. And if you click on View All, you have some more options. From the All Assignments screen, you can see everything your teacher has ever assigned you. The name of the assignment is on the left. In the center, it will have the due date if the teacher gave a due date for it. And on the right, it will be flagged as either assigned, missing, or returned. If it's been returned to you, it will also include a grade. So let's say I just want to see my graded work for this class. I would click on Returned, and there I can see each assignment and the score that was assigned to it. Likewise, if you click on Missing, you can quickly see which assignments you have not turned in by the due date. If the teacher did not assign a due date, they will not be flagged as missing. If you click on the back arrow, you will return to the class stream. Let's look on the right-hand side. You see the first assignment, and it's posted by teacher Christy Harp on April 23rd. It's labeled PE Activities, and it's a Word document. When you click on the Word document, you notice it opens. You can read the entire document. You can print the document. You can take a picture and send the document. You have full access to that document as a file. This particular document was not an assignment for my class, but it was a document that another teacher asked me to share with the entire 8th grade. If you click the back arrow, notice it takes you right back to the stream, and if you scroll down, you will see the assignment that I posted before this, or actually I should say the picture I posted before this. It was a keyboarding practice that, again, I was asked to share from the keyboarding teacher with all of the 8th grade. It is an image file that you can open and look at. It has the date and time. It does not have a due date because it's not for my class. But notice both of these allow you to make comments. Now, it's important if you choose to make a comment to remember that everybody can see the comment, and these are school devices, so you want to keep them school appropriate. But let's say you had a question or there was missing information, you would need to let me know or contact me, and this is one way to do it. And other people could also see your comment and even answer your question or your concern if I hadn't got to it quite yet. I just want to point out a few more examples of what you might see in the class stream. The first one is just where I've posted a question with a challenge for my students, and I have listed a website that they can go to at typing.com. In the middle, you'll see a purple assignment pad, and it says that Christy Harp posted an assignment, bonus assignment number 2. You can double click on that, open the assignment, follow the instructions, and turn it in. Third, you will see an invitation for students to join a Zoom meeting that we had with a link for them to follow and participate. Other things that could be posted to this class stream could include quizzes, or they could even include a Google Docs survey or something like that. So checking your class stream on a regular basis is very important. So look back at the top of the page. Remember, there are three tabs. The middle tab is called Classwork. Sometimes there's a lot of things posted in the stream that are very distracting, and so let's say you just want to get in and go straight to your work. If you click on the Classwork tab, you will see everything that has been assigned. and you can double click to open those assignments and follow the directions. Notice on the side it will have a due date, or your teacher may have an ongoing assignment with no due date posted. Here is an example of one of the assignments. If I click on bonus assignment number one, the directions say open this file and type directly on it. It is a Google Slides file, and as you edit it, it will record your responses and then you submit it to your teacher. Now notice at the top of this screen there is a tab for your Google Calendar, so we're going to open that and discuss that now. So once you open the calendar, you'll notice on the left you have the months and days. You can scroll through there and pick any month that you want to. You can see a couple different calendars if you look down on the left. The top one is checked, so that is Grace's personal calendar. There is also a check beside reminders, tasks, so that would be assignments. And if you look close to the bottom, you'll see there's a check beside all of her classes. So when teachers post assignments, if you look over on the calendar in purple at the top, there are two assignments posted that are due on April 5th, and they correspond to the color of the class down on the left-hand corner. Now you can add your own anything you want to this calendar. So all you do is at the top left where it says create, you click the create button. You name it whatever you want. So you could put band practice or dentist appointment, whatever you want to put. And you use the little clock to adjust the date and time that that happens. I know for teachers you can add guests. You may have to add like a group activity where you're meeting with your group members to work on a project. So you could send an email to them that they could join that meeting or acknowledge that y'all were going to meet at that time. You can even add a location and a description. All you have to do is click save and then you can see that on your calendar. Again, remember this is a school calendar, so you don't want to put anything too personal on there or anything obviously that's inappropriate. If we click back, we're back on the classwork page. Notice the last tab on the right says class drive folder. We're now going to open and look at that. Under the class drive folder, you will notice each of the assignments that have been opened and edited. This is just a quick, easy way to get straight to your work and continue editing what you've been working on or see what you already turned in and what it looked like when you turned it in. Finally, if you click back to the home page, you will notice the very last tab says People. At the top, any of your teachers for that class will be listed, and notice there is an envelope beside them. This means by just simply by clicking on the envelope, you can email your teachers to ask them questions. Also notice below that are your classmates. They also have an email address. Again, can't stress how important it is that this is a school system of email. So again, make sure it is appropriate and school related. And again, thanks for watching. Don't forget, you can always rewind and watch this video as much as you need. And there are other videos to explain different components that were not included in this video.